We need him to guide us. We need him to counsel us. We need him to comfort us. We need him to take care of us. We need him in a time of trouble. We need him to give us peace. We need him to be our father. We need him to be our mother. We need him to be our doctor. We need him for our finances. We need him for our health and our strength. And I'm here to tell you, congregation of Yahweh, and for those that are listening, we just need him. Do we understand? Because we cannot do it on our own. We need him. Hallelujah. Anybody in here today, or those that are listening on Facebook, on YouTube, that don't need him? Raise your hand if you don't need him. Now, am I right? I'm here to tell you, Brother Blackwell, need him. Because I'm here to tell you, if it was not for him, Brother Blackwell could not function. Huh, brother? I couldn't function. I couldn't do the things that I do if it wasn't for him. Because one thing I realized, Sister Julie, it's not me, but it's him. Am I right? Because without him, we would do nothing that's good without him. Hallelujah. But before we go any further, let us bow our heads and say a prayer. Hallelujah. My Heavenly Father, we come to you again because one thing we realize, without you, we can't make it. Without you, there's nothing done without you. So right now, my Heavenly Father, at this time, we're going to ask that you speak a word to us. Because, Father, we won't hear a word without you. We realize Yahshua is your son, and your son is the word of life. So we need to hear a word right now that will comfort us, that will strengthen us, that will acknowledge us who we are to you and who you are to us, making us realize we need you every day of our life. In a time of trouble, we need you. Father, when we are feeling lonely, when we are down and out, we need you to comfort us. My Heavenly Father, when our finances is just not right, we need you to be our finance. My Heavenly Father, because no one can give us a loan like you. Because that loan we don't have to worry about. Hallelujah, because you got it all. And you give us what we need and some things that we desire as long as we stay in your will. We realize that. So, Father, what we say to you today, have your way right now. In Yahshua's name we pray. Hallelujah. Can everybody say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Can everybody shout hallelujah? Can you give him a hand clap of praise and a hallelujah? Hallelujah! Hallelujah. Yes. Go ahead on and sing it. Yes. Yes, we need you. Yes, yes. Bless me. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes. Sing it. Savior. Hallelujah, we need you, Father. Yes. We need. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Everybody say yeah.
to your will. Yes, to your ways. Woo! Yes. My soul say yes down to the depth. Yes, he is. He did. Nobody but him. To you, Father. Yes. Yes, you have. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So good. Yes, you have. Yes, you have, Father. Yes, you have. Yes. You made. Yes. Yes. Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Well, we could say we had a praise service today, huh? Huh? We lift him up higher today.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Father. Yes. 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 Hallelujah. Father, have your way. Yes. Yes. Highest praise we can give to our Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeshua. Yeshua. Yes. He is wonderful. He is almighty. He is our Father. Yes. Hallelujah. Yeah. Father, we say it, have your way.
Have your way, yeah. Thank you.
Let your will be done in us, through us. In the name of Yahshua, the Messiah, our Savior of the whole universe. He shed his blood just for us, because of the love that he have for us. Through love and kindness have I drawn thee. And my Heavenly Father, we see how much you love us, how much your Son love us, because of the pain that he went through just for us. We were still in our sin, but yet and still he died, shed his blood, went through the pain and suffering before he died just for us. Hallelujah. But he said in his scripture, no man take my life from me, but I lay it down and I can take it up. I took it back up again. Death could not hold him. Am I right? A borrowed tomb, because he didn't need it, because it wasn't going to hold him. Am I right? Just for you, just for me, he done it all. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
He done it all just for us. Hallelujah. You know, last Sabbath we left, and I look around and I see the same ones here again, for those that was able to make it.
Hallelujah.
Am I right?
Thank you. Thank you.
Just, somebody say, just for me.
Just for me. Thank you.
And we show him how much we appreciate him by the things that he do for us. Not just one day.
Yes.
Hmm? Not just one time.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
But every day of our life,
yeah,
he is doing something for us. Hmm?
Yeah.
Every day of our life. But the question is, do we do something for him every day of our life? He don't have to be big.
Hallelujah.
Because that small thing is big.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
Don't take it for granted.
Yeah.
Every day of our life, sisters and brothers, those that are listening, we should be doing something for him. And you know my favorite scripture. What you do to the least of my little ones, you also do unto me. Hallelujah. What you do in secret, listen to me, sisters and brothers, what you do in secret, you have a reward openly.
Yes, hallelujah.
Do we understand?
Yes, hallelujah.
Huh? Hey, this morning, when my eyes open, when your eyes open, how many of us in here needed someone to speak for us? We open our mouth and we heard our own voice. Am I right?
Yeah.
I know y'all can hear me. I'm hollering right now, Ray J.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And as you look around, and as I look around, I see your feet and your legs, your knees and your hips are still in operation. They might be hurting. Huh? They might be hurting. My brother Alma. But they're still working. How do you understand? Hallelujah. When we was back there eating hot dogs and sandwiches, a little watermelon and whatever else we had in the back. You know, because sisters and brothers brought and they shared with one another. Like we do on, you know, on the Shabbat. Like we, for those that are not doing it, you should do it on the Shabbat that are listening. Showing love. Again. What you do to the least of my little ones, you also do unto me. Yeah. Now he's talking about the good and the bad. Yeah. Do we understand? Yeah. Now if you're doing somebody something wrong, you're doing it unto him. I want us to understand that. Yeah. And once we understand that, we'll stop sinning less and less and less. We'll stop doing wrong less and less and less. We'll start showing love more and more and more. We'll start treating one another good more and more and more. It's all about him. Hallelujah. Whether we like it or not, we are nothing unless we are in. Somebody say him. It's all about him. Hallelujah. You are still breathing his air. You're still able to see by his sunlight because he is the light of the world. Hallelujah. Now, is his light in you? Huh? Only you can answer that, because if his light is in you, it will shine out of you. Hallelujah. But if darkness is in you, then you will be dark. Hallelujah. You know, we finishing up. I guess we're going to finish this up today about coming out of dark. I did it about, I guess, a month ago and didn't get a chance to finish it because other people was preaching, you know, words that we needed to hear. Hallelujah. What did he say? I'm still going to speak the rest of what I need to speak unto us, because we need to hear this. Because it's not going to hurt you, but it's going to help you. Do we understand? Yeah. See, we do not come here, and I want those that are listening out there on radio, TV, YouTube, MyTube, Facebook, my face, outer space. I want you to hear this. You don't come to the congregation of Yahweh or any other congregation because you are a righteous person. I want us to understand that first. We are not here because we are so righteous. But we come here in order for us to learn how to be righteous. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because you got a lot of folks, I call them church folks, come to the church because they think they there are this righteous, upright person. But I'm here to tell you today, you are not. Because if you was, it wouldn't be no need for you to come here. Hallelujah. What are you talking about, Brother Blackwell? Brother Blackwell, glad you asked. Hallelujah. You see, we should be the way we act, some of us, in here, out there. Do you understand? If you are a child of the Most High, live like one, not in here, but out there. where you can win someone else. Those that are sick need a physician. And you could be the doctor for those that are sick that's out there in the world. Do you understand? But you come here in order to get right. That's what this place for to get those that are lost right. Hallelujah. Don't you just love him? Because, you know, sometimes he have to shock us in order to make us know who we are and who he is. Am I right? And right now we're being shocked into reality. Am I right? Hallelujah. Somebody cry out, bring me out of darkness into your marvelous light. Hallelujah. I'm glad we all in agreement. I'm glad we all want to go to the same place. Hallelujah. It makes it so easy when we all trying to walk in the right path of the Almighty. Hallelujah. What are you saying, Brother Blackwell? Well, what I'm saying is, when someone correct you in your wrongdoing, don't get upset. Love them. You understand? We need a Sister Julie. I don't know why I'm calling Sister Julie name. Sister Julie, I love you. Hallelujah. If Sister Julie correct me, I shouldn't get upset. Now, see, Brother BJ, I'm using myself for an example. Am I right? If she correct me, I shouldn't get upset. But I should get right. Am I right? Let me analyze. Let me check out what you're telling me, sister. Let me examine myself. Huh? And see where I need to come out of this dark place and to his more. That might be hindering me. Yeah. Am I right? There might be a weight that easily beset me and caused me to yield. Am I right? Now, when we come into his light, I want us to understand something. When we come into his light, we have no more fellowship with darkness. Not saying it's not going to come, because I'm here to tell you, it's always going to come. Sin is always going to be here. But as long as you don't tamper with it, you're going to be all right. Hallelujah. You know, we come here, we see sin. We go to the marketplace, we see sin. We go on our jobs, we see sin. In your own home, there's sin. But do not let sin come in you. Do you understand? We're coming out of this darkness. We're coming into his marvelous light. Now, why you are ingesting, digesting, or receiving, or believing, I want us to turn our scriptures over to Ephesians chapter 5. Hallelujah. Isn't he good? All the time he is good. But we don't receive him all the time because we want to be bad sometime. Hallelujah. We might as well own up to it. Huh? Tell the truth. The truth will make you free from darkness. Hallelujah. We got to love truth, Brother Jaden, huh? We got to love it. Because truth is life, peace, joy. Hallelujah. Long suffering, love. Hallelujah. That's why we need the truth. That's why we got to be real. Hallelujah. Let us read. Let's go down here to verse 8. 5 and 8. I tell you what. Let's back up. Let's start that first verse, Brother Shannon, if you don't mind. Because I love this one here. That's it, Brother DJ. Well, what that first verse said, read that one loud and clear.
Become then imitators of Elohim as beloved children.
As what?
Beloved children.
Beloved children. Dear children, let us walk. Everybody got it? Sister Betty? Okay. Brother Shannon, we're going to read that. Let's read that again, Brother Shannon, so everybody be on the same page. Yeah.
Become then imitators of Elohim as beloved children.
Listen at that. Now mine read it a little different, yeah, but it's saying the same thing. Yeah. Huh? Be ye their followers. Yeah. Huh? Followers. Not disobedient, but followers of what? Yeah. Of Yah as dear, beloved children. Yeah. How are children? Children honest. Hallelujah. Yeah. If a child look at something and it look bad to them, they gonna speak it out. Yeah. Am I right? And some of us grown folk, you know, when our children were small, they say something, come out their mouth, they'll speak in their heart. We sit there, be quiet, don't say that. Hey, am I right? Yeah. But they speak in their heart. That's the way we should be. If something don't taste good and you ask, you ask. Because you're not going to make me lie. You know how folks lie? Huh? But they say something made them lie. But if that lie is in you, it's going to come out of you. Am I right? Well, what the scripture says then? What do you say about a liar? And the truth is what? Not. If you are a liar, the truth cannot be in you. Just speak the truth. You cook some beans. You know, I love beans. Red beans, white beans. White is my favorite. And if they don't taste good, and you cook them, and if you don't want your feelings hurt, don't ask. Am I right? If you don't have nothing good to say, but don't ask. See, some of these small things, we say small, that's going to cause a lot of people to lose their life. Sin is sin. There's no such thing as big sin or small sin. You know, they talk about, I used to hear them holler about one little white lie. What is a white lie? I ain't never seen that in the scripture. Huh? And a lot of people practice these things and think they are biblical or true. But they're not. Search the scriptures and find in them you think you know the truth. But when you start searching, Sister Betty, you're going to find out it's not true. Paul fell from his horse. You know, things like that. Scripture don't never say he fell from it. He say he fell. And those that was with him fell. Because they had this bright light. Huh? Because he was in darkness at one time, Sister Betty. That's why he was going around killing folks. Thought he was doing almighty good service. He was killing righteous people. And to the point when he was blinded, they told him to go down to who house? Huh? Say it again. And what was Ananias done? And Ananias got scared. Who? Me? Pray for him? No, he's killing people. This man brutal. He's a murderer. But the Almighty spoke to Ananias and said, you is going to pray for him and the scales will fall from his eyes. Huh? He gave him a command. Am I right? Guess what? We got 10 over there. How many of us follow those? Hallelujah. But what did Ananias do? Huh? What did he do? He obeyed. Thank you, brother. Say it again. Speak it through the microphone. What did Ananias do?
He obeyed.
We no different than Ananias. See, when the light speak to us, we got to come out of darkness. Huh? We got to follow the light. You cannot be led in darkness, because how would I know where I'm going if I'm in darkness? Hallelujah. Let us read here. When I found out, dear children, verse number 2. What verse number 2 tell us, Brother Shannon?
And walk in love.
Listen at that. Just stop right there. Who is he talking to?
Us.
Huh? Somebody say his dear children. He's speaking to his dear children that have came out of darkness into his light. Now he's telling us, because he is the light that shines before us and leading us and guiding us in the right direction. Now he's telling us how we should be. Am I right? Now I know this not no new news to us. Am I right? But it's good news to us. It's being revived in us. Huh? We got a revival going on right now, Brother Shannon. Huh? Right, talking about a revival. Send me a revival. Well, you're getting revived right now. Every time you hear his truth, you being revived.
Hallelujah.
If you're not being following his truth, you know what I mean. Hallelujah. Now, what it says right here, Brother Shannon?
And walk in love.
Walk in love as
Messiah also has loved us.
Ooh.
And gave himself for us. A gift and an offering to Elohim for a sweet
smelling Savior. Listen, sisters and brothers. Listen what the Messiah done for you and I.
Hallelujah.
Because he loved you. He loved you, Brother Blackwell. You understand? He done this just for us. Now, the things that are coming up on this world today, most people in this world not gonna make it. And I'm not saying this to scare us, but all this evil that's coming, that's here and keep coming, if you are not in him, you will not make it. See, we like to talk about religion. I'm going to ask us, and for those that are listening, how many of us religion have saved us?
Nope.
How long has the Messiah been here? Somebody say for a long time. Somebody say before I was even born, he was working miracles before you came into this world. I want you to know that. But here we got the anti, the negative, and people talking about get ready. You know, like Christmas. That's one of the biggest festivals, celebration. Christmas is coming. You got folks that don't even go to church. You understand? They not even worshiping the Messiah. They're out there in the world. Don't even know what the building look like on the inside. But when Christmas comes, I don't seem like the majority, I ain't gonna say it seem like, but the majority of the world is getting ready for Christmas, going out spending money. Oh, it's a time of giving. Well, I'm here to tell you right now, it's a time right now of giving you the truth, giving you the word, and you better get ready. not for Christmas, but for the Messiah. Because I'm here to tell you, he is coming back again. Huh? Soon. Not for Christmas. You'll be getting ready for Christmas. Oh, it's a time. It's a joyful time. How is joyful when I cannot afford certain gifts, but I go down to Republic, or you're going to the bank, or you're going here, or you're going there, and you want to borrow money to make other people, or should I say to try to make other people happy by buying gifts. But you know, I done seen, I'm 53 years old, and I done seen in this world at that time of Christmas. We talking about Christmas right now. And I see people go out and purchase gifts. Other folks, they have a gift party, a gift giving, or a gift trading, or whatever. But when your gift don't amount up to the money that I have spent on your gift, somebody is mad. But you say it's a time of giving. Huh? Or you say it's the thought that count. But yet and still you mumbling and you complaining and you talking about the individual because of what they did not do that you done for them. And yet still you call yourself a righteous person. You call yourself celebrating the birth of the Messiah. Not one time he told us to celebrate his birth, but he did say remember his resurrection. And a lot of people don't even do that right. Hallelujah! Right. It's time for you to come out of your darkness. I know many folks get upset, especially when we talk about Christmas. Hallelujah. Celebrating the birth of the Messiah. Hallelujah. But I don't think the Messiah, well, I ain't going to say I don't think. I know the Messiah wasn't born in the winter months. Hallelujah. So somebody lying. Then you go to asking questions. Was the Messiah born on December the 25th? So why do the majority of the world, celebrate his birth? And then I look at this thing, sisters and brothers. There's no new news. It's been out for a long time. There's nothing new, but again, we're in a revival. Now, it's Yahshua's birthday. You say Jesus, some folks, his birthday. Okay, now, what I have seen in my years of being here, if it was my birthday, hallelujah, if it was my birthday, I see people wishing me happy birthday. And if they got a gift to give me, they gonna give the gift to me, not to you. Am I right? That's right. So something is wrong with that also. That's right. We being revived. We just making you aware of the things that you are doing and letting you see those things that you are doing are based on a lie. Now some people might go and get upset, but don't get mad with me. I'm just telling you the truth. I'm trying to help you. Let us be real. You call yourself a child of the Most High, then it's time for you to be like a child of the Most High. I ain't say act like one, but I say be one. Hallelujah. We just use that for an example to make you aware of some of the things that you are doing that's not right in him. But yet and still you say that you're a child of the Most High. But they got some folks would say, I don't care what you say. I'm still going to celebrate Christmas. But they don't realize it's not what I'm saying. It's what's the truth. Huh? The truth will make you free from that junk. Yes, hallelujah. Hallelujah. But listen. Brother Shannon. Read verse 2 again.
And walk in love.
Walk in love. Now, the question is, what is love? Huh? The question, he said, am I right, Brother Shannon? Read that loud and clear again.
And walk in love.
And walk. Now, who is he talking to, telling them to walk in love? His dear children. Yes. Well, we might not finish this, Brother Shannon, again, but it's okay. It's okay. I want us to understand, those that are listening. His dear children. Now, he ain't talking to no anybody. He's not talking to the world. Come on. You understand? He is talking to his dear children. This is a certain people here. I want us to know that. It's not for everybody. Talking to his dear children. I want you to understand. Ask yourself a question. Am I his child? Am I his dear child? And you can answer your own self because you know. Now the things is, if I am in his light and I'm no longer in darkness, I came out of darkness into his light, those things that I used to do back here, those thoughts that I used to think, those words that used to come out of my mouth, the thoughts that used to enter into my mind, I used to act on them, I no longer do that anymore. Am I right? Now, if you still practicing those same things, guess what? You have not came out of darkness into his light.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, if you asking the question, is he talking to me? Answer the question. Well, matter of fact, I'll help you. Yes. Hallelujah. Now, this might not be no shouting word for some folks. But we need to hear it. Huh, Brother Shannon? We need to hear this. Now, and I'm taking my time because I want to understand who he is talking to. And walk in love. What else it said, Brother Shannon, after that?
As Messiah.
As the Messiah. Huh? Brother Shannon, I ain't mean to cut you off. But I guess I did mean to cut you off. It's all good. As the Messiah. As the Messiah. Not as Satan. As many folks do. As a Messiah.
As Messiah also has loved us and gave himself for us.
Listen at that.
A gift. And an offering to Almighty God for a sweet smelling fragrance.
A gift, an offering unto the Almighty, just for you and me. Hallelujah. He done this. He was the perfect example for you and I, so we can follow his same footsteps. But the question is, how many of his children are following after him? Or yet we still in darkness and haven't came out of a darkness yet into his light. What's the next one say, Brother Shannon?
But whoring and all uncleanness are greed again. Let it not even be named among you.
Listen at this.
As is proper among set apart.
Listen at this. He even spoke some of it on Brother Shannon. Now, how many folks that thinking they're in the light and they're still in darkness doing these things that he say that we should be done came out of those things that we. Now, I'm here to tell you, sisters and brothers, you will have folks that's out there try to condemn you and say, oh, I remember what you used. Well, you can keep remembering all you want, because what I used to do ain't controlling where I'm going. That's not my future. My future is the kingdom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, many of us used to do bad things, used to think bad thoughts, used to do evil stuff. But our mind have been transformed into righteousness. We no longer walk in darkness. Darkness is behind us. We not walking back, but we are walking forward where the light is shining. That's what's guiding us into his righteousness. Do we understand? But many folks don't understand because they try to walk forward and still look back. But how can you see where you're going? You remember Lot. You remember Sodom and Gomorrah. You remember that story, those two cities. And what was wrong with those two cities? What was going on in those two cities? The same thing that's going on in America and these other countries. It's not just America. All these other countries, sin is going on. Huh? I wonder why he said, what I say unto one, I say unto all. That means all need to hear the truth. Hallelujah. See, sometimes I get loud, Brother Shannon, scream. That's just the way it come out. But all have sinned and came short. What I say unto one, I say unto all. The same thing that was going on in Sodom and Gomorrah, those two cities, that's what we see going on around the world today. Hallelujah. But Lot's wife, he said, I'm going to lead you all out of these cities. But what did he tell them not to do? What did he tell them not to do? What did he tell Lot's family not to do? Don't be scared to say it. Don't look back. I'm going to lead you out of those dark cities. Follow my light and don't look back. Now I can imagine, you know, in my spiritual mind, my family is walking. And they walk in the, you know, we got to walk careful. You understand? Because Satan been here for a long time. He's smooth. And if you let your guards down, I ain't gonna say he might get you. I'm gonna tell you he will get you. Smooth. So boy, the family walking, marching out of those cities. Hallelujah. Don't look back. Don't be influenced by the devil. Don't let Satan deceive you. Follow my light while I lead you out of darkness. Now, I don't know where Lot's wife was. I don't know if she was in the front, if she was right behind Lot. I don't know if she was in the middle. I don't know where, but it doesn't matter. Huh? But they walking, and they walking careful, and they watching. Now, I don't, y'all imagine this in your spiritual mind. They walking. Lot's wife. She couldn't turn to the left. I'm just ad-libbing here. Then all of a sudden, and she couldn't lie because he told her not to look back. Something will happen to you if you look back. If your eyes wander back. Mariah, I'm going to back up where you can see me. Hallelujah. I see Mariah all into this. She's looking around because I done stepped up too far. And I want you to imagine as she's stepping. And all of a sudden, Satan done got in her mind. Huh?
Yeah.
You know, like he do some of us, but not if all of us sometime. He get in our mind. Huh? I don't care what the words say, but I'm telling you, it's all right. Nobody's around. It's okay for you to, you could just do it one time. I know what your daddy said, but your daddy is not here. I'm your friend. I'm your girlfriend. I'm your boyfriend. And you find out you ain't no friend. I know what they said, but you don't have to obey them. Just one time. It'll make you feel good. And just imagine if you don't do this, everybody gonna be looking at you because you're not joining in with the rest.
All right, now come on.
Hallelujah. You ever been to a party and everybody up getting down and drinking and doing or getting drunk and all of you the only one sitting there sticking out like a sore thumb? I'm just here just to show myself to be friendly. Come on, take a drink. Hallelujah. You take one drink and it tastes pretty good. Yeah, take another one. Till you get to the point you don't even know you're at the party anymore. Hallelujah. You wake up the next morning, you didn't know how you got home. Hallelujah. You don't even know where you've been. Hallelujah. I can't remember what I done. Somebody might slip something in your drink unawares of. But that's your friend. There's somebody that say they love you more than your parents. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. More than your sister or your brother. Hallelujah. But Lot, wife, kept on listening to that voice. It wasn't Yahweh's, it wasn't Yahshua's voice. Hearing that voice, just turn around, look at what's going on back there. She couldn't resist him until she just turned around and looked. And for our understanding, that statue, that pillar of salt, is still there looking. Until the Messiah come back looking to be judged. Do we understand? All it take one time. No matter how big or how small, one time. He brought you out of darkness into his light. Don't look back. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Don't look back. Through his love, through his mercy, through his long suffering, through it all, he saved you. Because if you look back where you came from and look at where you are now, aren't you blessed?
Hallelujah.
Some of us, if not all of us, or most of us, probably would not even be here today if we had not turned from our evil and wicked ways unto his marvelous light. Hallelujah. But I'm here to tell you, sisters and brothers, I'm here to tell us, when sickness struck our body, we had no one to heal us. Through love and kindness have I drawn thee. We had no one to heal us that we know of. We didn't know, we knew of him, but we didn't know him. But he looking down on us. He allows certain things to come up on us to get our attention in order for us to see the light. Am I right? But we could have died in our sins. But he did not allow that to happen to us. Am I right? He's painting a picture for us to see how much what he done for you and me. Hallelujah. And he said, I could use you. Not Satan. But I'm going to use you. So I'm going to allow this to come up on you, bring you down so low, you have no other choice but to look up at me. And when you look up, I'm going to shine my light. I'm going to let you know who I am and what I can do. And I can bring you out of this situation. But when I bring you out of this situation, I want you to walk and follow after me. You understand? That's what he done for you. That's what he done for me. He got our attention. And he said, when I put you on this righteous road, don't get off. Don't look back, but keep marching forward. Do we understand? Now we're going to read a little bit more. Hallelujah. Well, where we at, Brother Shannon? That sweet smelling Savior. Wow. Verse number 3. No, verse 4.
Neither filthiness. Nor foolish talking.
Mm-hmm.
Nor coarse jesting.
Mm-hmm.
Which are not fitting. But rather thanksgiving.
Thanks. Do what? Thanks what? How much do we thank him for what he are doing for us all the time?
Hallelujah. Thank you.
How many times we done sit down and ate and we didn't even say our blessings over the food that we ate? They could have had poison in that food. Huh? Now I know we do it here. We do a lot here that we don't do when we're somewhere else. Do I need to say that again, Brother Shannon? Huh? We do a lot here together that we don't do when we're somewhere else. You know, sometimes we be ashamed of bowing our head praying over our food because they got a lot of other people around us that might not be children of the Most High. They might look at us a certain way. So what? Let them look at us. Because I'm here to tell you they're not ashamed to commit sin in front of you. Hallelujah! So don't you be ashamed to do righteous in front of them. Matter of fact, we need to do righteous in front of them so we can draw them out of darkness. Oh, look at them. They over there praying over their food.
As a family.
Holding hands.
Hallelujah.
Hmm. I might need to try that. Look at them. They all look healthy. They all look like they have joy. They happy. Look at them. They got Filipinos, what they call white people, what they call black. Look at all of them. They mix together. Look at them. They enjoy like one family.
Come on.
That's because we are.
Oh, yes.
Huh, Sister Betty?
Yes.
That's because of, huh, Sister Julie?
Yes.
Huh, Sister Dot?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Supposed to be going around here looking at color. What is color? Huh? You look at flowers, they got many colors in flowers. Am I right? But they all look beautiful together. That's when you know you done came out of darkness into his light. Hallelujah. Satan tries to use whatever he can. And many people don't understand that. What color have to do with me? What color have to do with you? You know how sometimes when things happen, somebody been murdered or whatever, and we all, I'm sure, are guilty of, what color was that? What does it matter? Sin has no respected person. I want you to understand that. Hallelujah. Now, you know, I look at the kingdom, and I never seen in the scripture where he spoke about, I'm going to have this color over here. I'm going to put that color there. And I'm going to put this. And I'm going to put that nationality. I ain't never seen that nowhere. Hmm? See, Brother Shannon, man makes that up.
All tribes.
All what?
All tribes from all nations.
All tribes from all nations. Mm-hmm. One people.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Satan uses all kind of tactics to separate people. And guess what? It works on the majority of the world. A lot of people are ignorant to what's going on. Hallelujah. Satan got your mind on something else when something here happening. He calls you to yield from what's right. Do you understand? But come out of your dark place. See his marvelous light and follow after it. Brother Shannon, let's read some more. I got much more, but like I said, we're not going to finish, but we're going to go until we go.
For this you know, that no one who is, and no one who boards, nor unclean one, nor one greedy of gain, who is an idolatry, has any inheritance in the reign of Messiah and of Elohim.
Listen at that. In the kingdom, no inheritance. Now, how can you say you are a child of the Most High, you are a righteous person, when you still practicing these things he just named out? Something wrong. You cannot be a child of the Most High and practice sin. There is a difference. There is a separation. Hallelujah. But you still have many folks. Oh, I've been going to church for 50 years. Oh, I've been going for 40. Well, how long you think Satan been going? Huh? Because he's in you. Hallelujah. You know, it have been said Satan follows you to church, and when you go in, he stays outside the door and wait for you. That's a lie. Huh? Do anybody disagree with me? That's a lie. Many people tell lies. Yep. But if Satan is in you, wherever you go, you're bringing him with you. Hallelujah. If you don't believe me, look at the churches that you done seen with all this disagreement, upright road that goes on in them. Yep. You got Sally, Sue, John still sleeping with one another. Hallelujah. I heard Brother William say it one time, this man said, two white sheets can't make you dirty. Oh, so since we going to the same church, we all right, we can mess around with one another. You got these kind of things being taught in churches. You need to check out the pastor. Hallelujah. Don't think it to be so, if Satan can transform himself into an angel of light, so can his ministers, so can his preachers, so can those stand behind the pulpit. Huh? He's talking about the pastors, talking about the preachers. How can the blind... Do I need to finish it? Can somebody help me out here? Both of them gonna fall in the pit of hell if they don't change. Now, I know this might sound harsh. You shouldn't be saying this. Well, you shouldn't be doing what you're doing either. The soul that stays in darkness will die. Hallelujah. I'm getting ready to stop for now. We're going to finish this out, Brother Johnny. I don't care if it take a whole month, but we're going to finish it. We need to hear and understand what we need to be doing and what we not ought to do. Hallelujah. Well, Brother Blackwell, it's impossible for us, you know, to not sin, to not, well, I write unto you, little children, that you sin not. But if so happen, you get weak. If you get weak, I have and what? Yahshua died for you. Yahshua paid the price that you can repent of that sin, get up and keep running. But I did not tell you to practice that sin. Don't use it for an excuse. Am I right? That's what many folks try to do. They use it for an excuse. Well, I can sin and I ask for forgiveness 70 times in one day, and he gonna forgive me. But have you ever thought about this, sisters and brothers, or for those that are saying that if you commit that one sin, ask for forgiveness and repent of it, and you move on, and then later on that same day you commit another sin and you're not able to repent of it, what you think gonna happen to you? Huh? You might die in that sin. You didn't have a chance to ask for forgiveness in that act. Why play Russian roulette with your life? See, folks do things just because they think they could get away with it. But that's not how it works. Because if you love him and he is in you and you are in him, you no longer think about committing sin before him because of the love that you have for him. Hey, am I right? I don't like my wife. I don't think about hurting her. I don't think about doing wrong because I love her. Am I right? And I pray to go the same for others that are married in here, that you love them. You won't hurt them. Love is not hurt. Love is just not a word. Love is action. Huh? Don't tell me you love me. I don't say this many a time. But show me that you don't even have to tell me you love me. But I can see your action. You know how they say actions speak louder than words? Hallelujah. They got husbands tell their wives all the time, baby, you know I love you. Hallelujah. But that bill that you made, you're going to pay for it. Not me. Hallelujah. You know, we talk about love in marriages. But you look at marriages and they are separated. Yeah. You got yours, I got mine. You got your bank account, I got mine. Now, do you need me to lend you some money? I want you to pay it back. Do that sound? I don't want none of y'all to get in trouble. Oh, you heard Brother Blackwell sit in the pulpit, huh? You wait till we get home. I don't get on a phone call tonight. Brother Black, what you meant when you said that? Why? Because we got trouble in the house. Love is an action word. The Messiah did not tell us that he loved us, but he showed us that he loved us. Hallelujah. He didn't have to tell us. Imagine when he gave himself, gave himself for you and I, our forefathers, those that were still in sin, gave himself, looking at us in sin, see us wallowing in sin. But yet and still he said, I'm going to give my life for them. I'm going to shed my blood. I'm going to go through this pain, pulling out the beard, slapping the face, nailing the thorns on his head, all these things. I'm looking at them, they're in sin, but I'm still giving my life for them. I'm looking at you, the ones that are hurting me right now, crucifying me right now. I'm giving my life for you. You don't even realize that you could come out of your sins because you don't understand what's going to happen. You don't understand. When I lay down and go in the tomb, I'm not dead. But I'm doing this for an example for you. Those same ones that hurt him, slapped him, pulled his beard out. Those same people, he gave his life for them. Do we understand how serious the Messiah is for us? For us. We can go right out there on that highway, go home, get in a bad accident, and get killed. If not killed, we can get busted up real bad, paralyzed. Or we can lose our voice, won't be able to talk anymore. All these things can happen to you and I. But he did not allow that. He protect us. Even when we are not doing right, those children of Mosiah are not doing right, he's still having mercy on you and I. Do we understand that? Come out of darkness, Yahshua. Some of us in here take medicine for certain things. If we did not take the medicine, we would stay sick. We could die. Would he allow a man to practice medicine? Some of us in here, if not all of us in here, them had some type of surgery. It wasn't man. He guided the knife. He gave them the knowledge how to do this. Some of us, our body being cut wide open. And I can say this because I've seen it. I'm following Auntie Audrey when my wife was having Mariah, a miracle, one of them. Come over here, Wesley. Listen to her. And I almost fell out. Body open. I'm sitting there like, how can they do this? And sew them right back up like nothing ever happened. Who do you think that was? Yeah. Nobody but Yah. Brother Armin. Back surgery. Knee surgery. He's still walking, not paralyzed. I remember I had a surgery, had one of my saliva glands removed. And the lady was talking to me and I'm getting scared like, I have to let you know this, but I'm going to be real careful. I done did many surgeries, but if I touch certain nerves, you know, it could cause damage. You might not be able to talk no more. And I'm like, well, I don't want the surgery. But those things, sisters and brothers, can happen while we under anesthesia. We could die just being under that. We don't understand. Who you think this is? How do you think where you think they got this knowledge from?
Thank you, Father.
Nobody but Almighty Yahweh.
Yes.
And he still got to lead and guide them through all of this. We don't understand. Every one of us came out of our mama's womb. Lived how many months in water? And some didn't even live to 9. Had to take them. Miracle in Mariah, I know for example. Hallelujah. When we start thinking about what the Almighty does for us every day of our life, it will cause you to come out of darkness, seeing less and less. Do more for your sisters and your brothers and strangers.
Thank you, Father.
We don't even know. I saw a woman the other day, a couple of weeks ago, broke down on the side of the road, flat. Her and her daughter. Passed by, looked over there. I couldn't do it. Because I'm trying to hustle and go on work and get out of the heat. Couldn't do it. Found somewhere to turn the trailer around and go back and help her. And then when he got there, the spare was on a flat. But the Father blessed. Took the air tank out, blow the tire up, put it on. And I'm not saying this bragging on me because it wasn't me. But I'm showing by an example the things that we ought to do.
Yeah.
That we ignore most of the time. But you know what I always look at? I always say, well, that could be my daughter. That could be my wife. That could be my mama. That could be my auntie. That could be one of you that's out there in that hot sun broke down. And how would I want somebody to do me?
Come on, man.
Do unto others as you would have them to do unto you. See, when you start thinking about the commandments and thinking about what the word says, I guarantee you it will change your life. Do you think he gave us that just for us to have? Or do you think he gave that for us to live by?
To live by. Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah. Somebody prayed for me. You understand? I know somebody prayed for me. Had me on their mind. You know, we sang that song. Took out time and prayed for me. And I can say, I'm so glad they prayed.
Yes.
Hallelujah. What about you? What about those that are listening right now? We got to be more, we from the pulpit back got to be more attentive to what the Spirit speaks to us. And I'm here to tell you, sisters and brothers, you could try to ignore it all you want, but I'm here to tell you, I want you to have an open ear to hear. Keep your mouth closed, because you know most time when we talking, we can't hear nothing. Am I right? We'll be talking too much. But I want us to listen at what the Spirit is saying to us every day of our lives. Because I'm sure the Spirit is telling you to do something for someone. Because all of us fall in need from time to time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All of us. And the Spirit might be telling Brother Flynn, go see Brother Blackwell. And I ain't talking about money. Most folks think, oh yeah, I need some money. Money. And after you get that money, then what? Because when you spin it up on Brother Flynn, then what? Might send Brother Flynn over by my house just to listen at me. That's all I need. You understand? Someone just to vent.
Yeah.
You sit right there and vent. I tell Brother Flynn, thank you, Flynn, for coming over. Hey, bro, just being led by the Spirit. Told me you need me here. Hallelujah. Secret, but rewarded openly. Do we understand? Brother Stanley. Yeah, Brother Stanley back in the house with us. Brother Stanley, I want you to know we miss y'all. Saw Sister Elta, didn't see you. We miss y'all. Hallelujah. But we thank the Father. I'm going to stop right here. But we thank the Father for what he have gave us so far. And again, I thank him for the praise that we had today. Beautiful. And I say praise, but it was also healing, as Brother BJ said. Huh? We stop and pray, but it was a shout unto the Father that healed our bodies. Those that, you know, some of us might be sick and don't even realize it. How many times have he healed us? We don't know. Hallelujah. Blessed us. This woman, Mary, he did something for her. Blessed her. But our sister wanted to show him how much she appreciated him. She had this precious box of ointment, spikenard, worth some money, but she didn't think of the money. She was thinking about what the Messiah, our Savior, done for her. No money couldn't do it. So that money, that oil, best thing that she had. She wasn't worried about how much it cost. But she wanted to anoint our Savior. And she did that. In spite of the complaining, ridicule. What's wrong with you? Don't you know this oil is worth money? Don't you know you can sell it? Take that money, you can get the money to the poor. But Yahshua said, leave her alone. And all he had to speak was one time. They knew he meant it. Leave her alone. But she is preparing me for my burial. She is getting ready to do a good work for me. And see them poor people you talking about? Those people, poor, are going to always be around. But I'm on my way back. And you talking about the poor, I could take care of them as well as you. But no doubt in his mind, he wasn't concerned about them people. Might have been thinking about he could have got his hands on it all and got the money. Yahshua told his disciples, whenever you speak about me, tell the people, any of my preachers, teachers, I want you to let the world know what she have done for me. Matter of fact, I want it to be a memorial unto her. Good example, sisters and brothers. Now, we look at that good example for us, and we speak this after his word, speaking about him, and we tell the people what Mary done. For an example for you and I, because of the good that she done, took the best thing that she had and offered it unto the Messiah. You understand? So when we see someone, and I say this often, but when we see someone that's in need, when we see someone that's in need, if you are able to meet their need, you don't have to ask. Just do it. If you're not able, find someone who is. You understand? Find someone who is and meet the need. It could be a stranger. It doesn't matter. Hallelujah. Because once you done good, you move on. Plant the seed. Yahshua, Yahweh, gonna get the increase. But you know how we do sometimes. We want to get the increase. We want to get this. We want to get that. Hallelujah. But it wasn't you. It's Yahshua in you. Hallelujah. Remember, sisters and brothers, I'm going to say this, and I keep saying it, and I keep saying it, and I keep saying it until I leave this place. What you do to the least of my little ones, you also do unto me. Hallelujah.